Hello there, my name is Dominic and today I'm going to show you how to connect an MP3 player to your equalizer. This video has been requested by some of you, so here we go. In this video, I'm going to cover how to connect power to the MP3 player, and in this section, I'm going to show you something about voltage regulators. Then we are going to cover how to connect signal from the MP3 player to the equalizer, and finally, we're going to conclude with a simple sound test. These MP3 player boards are usually very versatile and cheap. For example, this one will cost you around 200 to 300 Kenya shillings, which is less than $4 with shipping on AliExpress. Now let's talk about the inputs. For example, this one has auxiliary input, USB, memory card, and FM radio. So that is a whole hi-fi system. We just need amplification. To connect our MP3 player to the equalizer, we require very few tools and materials. You require a side cutter to cut the wires. If you don't have a side cutter, then a normal pair of scissors will work fine. You need a screwdriver, and that's for either removing these screws for ease of access or maybe attaching this MP3 player to your box. You need insulating tape to connect the wires together, a short pair of RCA cables to connect the signal between the MP3 player and the equalizer, and we don't need a soldering gun for this project and any solder. I'll try and finish this project without soldering anything. I'm just going to use insulating tape and my hands to fix the wires together. As far as the power supply is concerned, this is what I'm going to use for my project. This is a 12 volt 2 ampere power supply, but a 12 volt 1 ampere supply will power both the equalizer and the music player. But note that if you have a powerful power supply, then you can power the music player, the equalizer, as well as your car audio amplifier. And I'm talking about something like a computer server power supply. In this video, I will not connect the equalizer to this car audio amplifier because I already have a video about that. What I'll do is that I'll connect it to these two small amplifiers here for our music tests. So please stay tuned till the end of the video for that. This MP3 board came with two cables, one for the power supply and another one for the signal out, as well as a remote control. It's a very nice product. As for the power supply, this one is labeled as 5 volts. And again, even though I have soldered mine, you don't need to solder anything. These things usually just have clips. And this is for the signal out that includes an antenna. The red cable you can see here is labeled as antenna. And then we have out, right, ground, then out, left. It's very straightforward. The three ports labeled left in, ground, and right in are line in ports. You can solder your female RCA connectors externally to use those ports. But that's exactly the same points as this auxiliary port. Instead of soldering and connecting female RCA line input, this is what we'll do instead. For example, if you have a decoder, you'll use such a cable. The red and white will go directly into the audio out on your decoder, and then you can feed your audio using the 3.5mm audio jack to the aux input. Simple and straightforward. Now, if you're keen, you noticed that this one is written as 5 volts, but my power supply is rated at 12 volts. So what's happening with that? Well, let's talk about voltage regulators. If you take a look at this board here, you can see this IC labeled as CS78M05. That is a voltage regulator. The work of a voltage regulator is to give out a constant voltage. For example, 5 volts. If we give this IC 12 volts, then we're going to get 5 volts out. Any IC that you see has 7805 is a voltage regulator. Sometimes, for example, we saw ours has 78M05 and this other one has CW7805. The 7805 means this is a voltage regulator. The first two digits denote that it's a voltage regulator and the last two digits denote the output voltage. So for example, 7805 is for 5 volts, 7812, 12 volts, and 7824 is 24 volts output. Now, because we have a voltage regulator inside here, I can confidently connect this thing to 12 volts. But the voltage regulator will supply 5 volts to the internal components. I hope everything is clear now. In some AliExpress listings, you will see the input voltage labeled as 5 or 12 volts compatible. And that's because of the voltage regulator. With my 12 volt power adapter connected, if I turn the power on, it should turn on, and already it's on. Now, let's connect the equalizer to this exact power supply because even this uses 12 volts. On the equalizer, the remote and battery wires should be connected together, and this should be connected to the positive terminal of our power supply or adapter. And the black cable or the ground should be connected to the negative power supply. Ground and negative mean exactly the same thing. If I now turn on the power, both of these devices should turn on. Very nice. And now let's connect the signal from the music player to the equalizer. But before I do that, let me clean up this mess using insulating tape. That looks much better. This is the cable for the signal output from the MP3 player, and it can only go one way inside here, so you can't connect it opposite. When we look at the bottom labeling, we can see that the first cable, which is the red cable, that is for your FM antenna. If you have an external antenna, you can connect it to this other end. The next wire is for the audio out right. So just trace the next cable, which is this one, and with this I'll just connect it to one of the wires here, the internal one. Please make sure your RCA connectors are fine and they will not disconnect when bent at this point. Make sure they are fine. So that is for the right channel. Then we trace the other one. The other one is for the ground. I've already connected the two grounds together to this point. So the next cable will be the ground that I will connect here. And again, you can see we didn't need any solder or soldering iron to complete this project. And the last one is the audio out left that I'll just connect to the remaining cable. This is the most critical part. Please don't get confused on this part. Now the middle or ground cable is connected to these outer parts, and the yellow one is connected to this one, and the white one is connected to this other tip. Again, I'll just use some insulating tape and clean this up nicely. Just make sure the wires won't touch each other when you wrap it like this. And now for the audio input from the equalizer. We are either going to use the radio or the auxiliary input. So I can either connect it here or here. And to select radio, you use this button here. If it's outside, that is radio. If it's inside, that is auxiliary. That's radio and auxiliary input. Another thing to note, if you're going to mount this thing inside a box, please make sure that your signal wires are mounted on one side of the box and the power wires are mounted on the other side of the box to avoid distortion in the audio output. And please avoid having a transformer inside your box because that will also bring distortion. I recommend just using an external power adapter to avoid those problems. And now I need to connect the audio output to my two amplifiers. This is a mid-range amplifier and this is a subwoofer amplifier. I have a review of these two amplifiers on my channel, so please check the video description below. And this is the final music system setup. Let me explain a few things before we go into a music test. That is the mid-range amplifier connected to these two speakers. And this is a subwoofer amplifier board connected to this 30 centimeter subwoofer speaker. Both are powered using this 19 volt laptop adapter. Our equalizer as well as the MP3 player are powered by the 12 volt adapter. You can see we have two different power supplies here. That hum you can hear from these speakers, that's not coming from the MP3 player. The cause of that hum is this amplifier. It's so bad, I even tried to wrap it with this foil. Even if I touch it, you can hear it change. Yeah, it's so bad. Now the signal outputs. The front output is connected to the mid-range amplifier, and the subwoofer output is connected to the subwoofer amplifier. What I've done is I've soldered the points just below these connectors. This phone is connected to the music speaker's MP3 player by Bluetooth. You can even see, I can even control the volume. These are my controls. That's for the subwoofer. If you're going to buy your MP3 player, then I have some advice for you. Number one, avoid those MP3 players that have a mute pin. They are a pain to deal with because this mute pin, you either connect it to power or to ground so that you can disable that mute function, but you don't know which one is which because these things do not come with a user manual, leave alone the service manual. So please avoid those ones with a mute pin. And number two, for a project with an equalizer, please avoid those MP3 players with inbuilt amplifiers. They are those gadgets that you just connect to power then to speakers directly. They have inbuilt amplifiers. This one does not. So if you're going to try this project out, please avoid those MP3 players with inbuilt amplifier. That's it. I hope you learned something new today. Please watch the related videos in the video description below as well as in the pinned comment. Subscribe if you haven't. Share this video with your friends. Let's meet in the next video and goodbye.